हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द एसआई यूनिट सिस्टम एंड द डिफरेंट टेक्निक्स विच आर अवेलेबल ग्लोबली फॉर द मेजरमेंट्स ऑफ फिजिकल क्वांटिटी। सो इट इज़ द बेसिक नीड फॉर अ फिजिकल क्वांटिटी टू बी मेजर्ड इन पर्टिकुलर मैनर। सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन विच कम्स इन टू माइंड इज दैट वॉट शुड बी द यूनिट ऑफ अ फिजिकल क्वांटिटी। सपोज वेन यू आर कंसिडरिंग योर वेट, यू आर मेजरिंग इट इन किलोग्राम और ग्राम। सो वेन द स्टैंडर्ड मेजर ऑफ एनी क्वांटिटी इज कैरिड आउट इज कॉल्ड अ यूनिट ऑफ दैट फिजिकल क्वांटिटी। एंड द ग्लोबल क्राइटेरिया विच आर यूटिलाइजिंग फॉर द यूनिट आर एज फॉलोज। नंबर वन, द मेजर ऑफ अ यूनिट शुड बी डिफाइनाइट एंड अनएम्बिगियस। नंबर टू, द यूनिट शुड बी सच दैट इट्स मेजर शुड नॉट चेंज। एंड इफ़ अ यूनिट इज डिफाइंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ सम फिनोमिनन देन दैट फिनोमिनन मस्ट बी परमानेंट। नंबर थ्री, the prototype which is replica of a unit should be easily reproducible and easily available. So these three are the conditions which is to be fulfilled when you are desiring a unit for a particular physical quantity. So some known physical quantities are mass, length and time. So the mass is measured in kilogram, also in gram or in the milligram. The length is sometimes measured in meter, moreover it is also measured in kilometer and centimeter, and the time is again measured in hour, minute or second. So the units of physical quantities and the systems of units which are now at present available in the global market. Although the number of physical quantities is very large, we need only a minimum or limited number of physical quantities for which units should be the units of all other quantities can be expressed and defined with the help of others. These minimum physical quantities, which are known as fundamental quantities, or you can say the base quantities, and hence their units are called fundamental units or base units. And the other physical quantities which have been determined with the help of these fundamental quantities are known as derived physical quantities, and again their units are called derived units. The different types of system of units have come into the existence at different places and times. These systems are, number one, which is FPS system, which is well known British measurement system, where the length is measured in foot, weight or mass is measured in pound, and time is measured in second. The second system is CGS system, where the length is measured in centimeter, mass is measured in gram, and time is measured in second. Number three, that is the MKS system, where length is measured in meter, mass is measured in kilogram, and time is measured in second. The fourth system is the extended MKS system, where one more parameter of electric current is introduced, and it is known as MKSA system, where length is measured in meter, mass in kilogram, time in second, and electric current is in ampere. And as you can see from these four systems, there are different types of units have been utilized in different systems. So when a particular research is carried out, so it has some globally uniformity, and in order to maintain this uniformity, SI system have been introduced with seven base or fundamental units, and the SI system is known as system of international. The international system of unit was accepted in 1971 by the 14th General Conference on Weights and Measures under the leadership of International Bureau of Weights and Measures, which were located at Paris in France. So the seven fundamental quantities which have been accepted in SI system of units are as follows. Number one is the length, measured in meter, symbol is small m. Number two is the mass, measured in kilogram, symbol is small kg. The third quantity is time, measured in second, symbol is small s. The fourth base quantity is electric current, measured in ampere, unit is capital A. Thermodynamic temperature, globally measured in Kelvin, symbolic representation is capital K. Amount of substance is the sixth base quantity, which is measured in mole, and the symbolic representation is small mol. Luminous intensity, which is measured in candela and the symbolically represented in small cd. So these three are the units of base quantities which were globally accepted in the SI systems. So now we switch over to the derived units. All the other units of different physical quantities can be expressed as a combination of these seven base units. So all the other quantities, or you can say physical quantities particularly, can be easily determined using all these seven or fundamental base quantities. For example, if you have to find out the SI unit of acceleration, so acceleration is the velocity upon time. So velocity is again distance upon time or displacement upon time. So acceleration is nothing but displacement upon time square. So unit of displacement is meter, time is the second, so meter upon second square. So mathematically it can be expressed as meter per second square or ms raised to minus 2. The another example has been carried out for the physical quantity work. Work is the force into distance, W is equal to F into D. So we know the unit of force, mass into acceleration, so that is kilogram into meter per second square. Unit of displacement is again meter, so the unit of work is kilogram into meter square per second square. So here in these two examples of acceleration and work, the derived units have been determined using the fundamental or base units. Now one more physical quantities which we have to consider over here is supplementary physical quantity. So only two supplementary physical quantities have been introduced to understand the three-dimensional or multiple dimensional Cartesian system. Number one is the plane angle, which is measured in radian, and its symbolic representation is small rad. Number two physical quantity is the solid angle, which is omega. Plane angle has the symbol theta, solid angle has symbol omega, which is measured in steradian, and the symbolically representation is capital S small r. So this is the plane angle, which is the two dimensional system, and this is the cubic form, which is known as solid angle. So how can you define the SI system of unit? So what are the practical norms? This is the 3 marks question for your GTU examination, and you have to write down all these 5 parameters. Number one is the unit of every physical quantity should be represented according to its symbol. This is the most important. Whenever you are writing the unit of particular physical quantity, you have to fulfill all these criterias. So when the physical quantity, suppose I am taking length, so I have to write the unit meter as small m, not I have to use the full form like meter. This is wrong. I just have to use the symbol of small m. Number two, no full stop should be used within or at the end of the symbol of a unit. So when you have write down the unit, there is no need to have some full stop. Here the example of kilogram is given, kg should be written instead of kg dot or k dot g dot. Number 3, which is the important criteria, symbols for units do not take plural form. For example, when you are using the meter symbol, you have to write down for multiple meters, like you have to write down for 100 meters. So you have to write down only 100 m, not 100 meters. It is wrong. Just you have to add the number quantity in the numerical form. The units of physical quantities, numerator and denominator, should be written as one ratio only, like we have shown in the example of force, which is mass into acceleration, kilogram into meter per second square. So either you can write down like this or in this particular form, but this is wrong. M upon s is wrong. You have to write down like meter per second square or m s raised to minus 2. The fifth condition, which is again very important, full name of a unit when it is named after a scientist, like the thermodynamic temperature is expressed in Kelvin because it has been introduced by the scientist Kelvin. So we have to use the capital letter in the symbolic representation of that unit, but the symbol for that unit has a capital letter. For example, the unit of force should be written as Newton. When you have to write down the full form, all the letters will be in the small caption, and when you have to write down the capital letter, so you have to use the initialization of that particular scientist, like capital N for Newton. The unit of pressure is Pascal in symbol, and it is written as capital P small a. So this way, or these norms, you have to follow for the use of SI system. So this was the basic starting of your first unit, SI systems and measurements, with which we have now been aware with the physical quantities, the two parts of physical quantities, fundamental and derived, their units. We have seen some different measurement techniques or systems available in the global market, and finally we have ended up with SI systems, and we have also shown the practical norms for the use of the same. So thanks for visiting this lecture.